Hi, welcome to this video presenting the synchronization of LDAP accounts with Gespage. If you don't have yet Gespage installed on your environment, we recommend you to watch our installation tutorial. The LDAP synchronization allows Gespage to create in its database the user accounts from your directory. Some main fields of each user are synchronized, like ID, name, email address, and other optional fields such as card number. Please note that the user's passwords are not synchronized. It is possible to synchronize accounts from an Active Directory or Open LDAP. In this video, we are going to present you the following elements: AD synchronization, Open LDAP synchronization, advanced synchronization settings. First step, log in on the administration page of your Gespage. Once logged in, go to the Server, Configuration, Account Management and LDAP Synchronization tab. To do this, it is necessary to have some information that we will detail later. In the case of an AD, you will need the address of the AD server, the domain name and an account with reading rights on the directory. Once you have entered the information, you can already test by pressing the Synchronize button. Gespage will then launch the synchronization script. Once the synchronization is complete, two results may be possible: synchronization is successful. You can find your accounts in the Accounts tab. Synchronization fails. You have an error message that appears in the top right corner of your screen. Additional information about the error can be found in the Monitoring, Event Log tab. Now let's move on to the case of Open LDAP. The necessary information is the same with a few exceptions in the syntax of some fields. The domain name must be entered with its DN. The account must be the administrator and filled with the full CN. The last point is the one called Unix Domain LDAP. This information is to be entered when the controller manager under Open LDAP is located on a different OU than all other users. By default, all accounts are defined in People. There are a large number of Gespage parameters related to synchronization. We will detail some of them in this tutorial. By default, we retrieve fields such as user ID, name, email address, home directory. However, you have the possibility to initialize most of the fields that make up a Gespage user with custom fields retrieved from your domain controller. As these fields are not standard at AD, LDAP level, you must define their identifier in the directory. The most common examples are the print code and the card number, which can, for example, be synchronized with the field www homepage. There is a user quota system in Gespage. You have the possibility to initialize the limitations of your users during the first synchronization of the accounts. According to your configuration, Gespage will then allocate a quota defined by you at the creation of users from your LDAP server. If you want to apply different settings for different user categories, you can define several directory configurations and filter each configuration using the root organizational unit or import filter fields. When your synchronization is functional, you can define the synchronization frequency. You can define a periodic synchronization, for example every 2 hours with 120 as a parameter, or define a daily synchronization time such as 2 a.m. Also, remember to set up the deletion of obsolete accounts. You can define a number of security days before deletion in Gespage. Finally, it should be noted that the Gespage synchronization script can be customized on demand, which makes it possible to interface with more complex directory configurations. For more information on this subject, contact your Gespage contact. That's it, you are now able to synchronize your domain controller to your Gespage server. Do not hesitate to contact Gespage support for more information or consult the Gespage manual. Thank you all for watching this video. For more information, go to www.gespage.com.